This video will show how to create the following two small PHP programs. First, creating a new PHP file in an empty directory, implementing it with a trivial program, printing the classical phrase "Hello World" to the screen. Then the "Hello World" program will be replaced with another program, which receives input arguments from the command line and also receives keyboard input from the user. This video is part of at least one playlist showing how to do the above with different programming languages. There should be a link to that playlist in the description below. Prerequisites. You, the viewer of this video, are assumed to have some skills in at least some programming language. I will not explain basic concepts such as what is a variable or what is an array, or what is a for loop. Even if you have never written source code with PHP, you are assumed to be able to understand, for example, what this PHP code below does. In this video, I am using Windows 10, and I start by showing which version of PHP I have installed. The version of PHP is 8.0.10. The Windows command dir shows that I am starting from an empty directory. Now I am creating a new directory called PHP with the Windows command md. Then I navigate into the new directory with cd php. Then I start Visual Studio Code by typing code and a dot, which is the path to the current directory. When Visual Studio Code has started, I create a new PHP file, arguments_inputs.php. In the new PHP directory. When writing a PHP script, you do not need to enter the code in a function or class with a main method, which is needed in many other programming languages. You can instead write code in the file directly on a file global level, outside of any function or method in the class. Now I implement the initial trivial PHP script by calling the print function to print "Hello World" to the screen. PHP files should also start with ? PHP. Then I am showing with the Windows command dir that the PHP file has been created in the PHP directory. The PHP script can now be executed by typing PHP and then the file name. When the script is executed, "Hello World" is shown on the screen, just as expected. Now I will replace the initial "Hello World" implementation with a program that will receive and print arguments from the command line. The program will also ask the user to enter a name and will then print to the screen what the user typed. For this purpose, I have prepared some pseudocode that I will paste into the program, but in comments, since of course it would not be possible to execute. Then I will modify the code by changing it to PHP code that can be executed. Now I am showing how the program arguments will be provided to the program when it is executed. The arguments will be added after PHP and then the name of the PHP file, and then a space between each argument. So here I am showing three arguments for the program. As you may know, dollar signs are used as prefixes for variables in PHP. Any program arguments are available in an array named $argv. I am iterating that array with a foreach loop, and I choose $arg as the name of the iterated element. Inside the loop, the iterated program argument is printed to the screen by calling the print function. The string created in that print call begins with \m, since I want the text to be printed on a new line for each iteration. \m represents the line break character. When I execute the script with three arguments, it does not work quite as expected. The very first so-called argument contains the name of the file being executed. Since I wanted to print only the actual program arguments, I will change the code so that the first element is not printed. This can be done in different ways. One way is to use the ArraySlice function that returns a new array from the index that is the second argument, the offset argument. It is shown here in the inset image. Here I am using index 1, which means the second element in the array. And from there, the actual program arguments begin, since the first element is the file name. Another way to avoid the first argument, which I will now show, is to create a filtered array that will contain all elements of the $argv array, except the first element. In other words, all elements except the element with index 0. I am using the array filter function, and the first argument is the array to be filtered. The second argument to the array filter function should be a function that takes one argument, a key or index for the filtered array, and it should return a Boolean value, which specifies whether or not to keep the element in the array with that key or index. The returned Boolean value is true or false, depending on whether the current key or index value, $i, is equal to 0 or greater than 0. Here I am defining the function as a so-called arrow function that works with PHP 7.4 or later. I will later show an alternative way to create a function as an argument, which also works with older PHP versions. Note that in this type of function, an arrow function, you do not need to explicitly write return to return the Boolean value, but it will still be returned from the function. The third argument, array filter use key, for the array filter function indicates that it is the key, not the value, of the elements of the iterated array, which should be the argument to the function, which is the second argument to the array filter function. When I then execute the program again, you can see that now it works exactly as expected. Note that now the name of the PHP file is not printed as a first program argument. Now I will show an alternative way to filter an array without using the modern arrow function syntax. First, I indent the existing code to make it more visible. Then I disable it with comments. And now I will show how to define the function for PHP versions older than 7.4. Instead of an arrow function with fn, you can write a regular function. But note that then you must also explicitly return a value with the keyword return, which you do not have to do with an arrow function, which also returns the value, but without having to write return. When I then execute the program again, you can see that it now works just like before when an arrow function was used. Now I will show another way to print the program argument from index 1. You can simply iterate the elements in the $argv array with a for loop instead of a foreach loop. If you want to iterate all elements, you start from index 0. But because I only want to print the elements from the second element, I will loop from index 1 instead. The count function returns the number of elements for the array, which is an argument to the count function, the array being looped. Now I also delete the previous code that used the array filter function. When I execute the program again, you will see that it still works exactly as before, when the array filter function was used. Now I will implement the second part of the program, that is, to receive input from the keyboard while the program is executed. I will show this with two alternative functions, readline and fguess. The question, what is your name, is printed with the print function on the line where an input prompt will be displayed. Since I want the input prompt to appear on the same line, I do not use \n at the end of the string being printed. First, I use the readline function for the first alternative way of reading input from the keyboard that I will display. That function returns the string that the user entered, and I receive it into a variable $name. Then I print the content of the variable $name with the function print and the text hello as prefix. \n is used at the beginning of the string to create an additional line break first. When I execute the script, you can see that it works as expected. Now I will show an alternative way to read input from the keyboard. Instead of the readLine function, you can use the fgets function with the argument stdin. stdin stands for standard input, which usually means the keyboard. When I now execute the script, you can see that it works almost as when using the readLine function, but with the difference that it includes an additional line break at the end of the variable $name. This problem can be easily fixed by using the function trim to remove so-called white space, for example, line breaks at the beginning and end of a string. When I now execute the script again, you can see that the result is the same as when the readLine function was used. In other words, no additional line break at the end of the $name variable is printed to the screen.